The datasheet control is an add-in to ProcessBook that allows you to display PIUnit batch information and also allow you to create an interactive application where you can enter values against an alias or point. This is a screenshot of how it looks, and let's shift over to ProcessBook and show you or give you an illustration of how this looks. I'm going to go into build mode and click on the datasheet control button in the toolbar. And I'm going to draw a rectangle across my screen. And it's essentially asking me what I want to look at, what unit. And I'm going to go and pick my favorite pulp company example here that we've been working on all week. And I want to see the chip screener. I want to see all the values from the chip screener. Now I can either create my own entries, or I can use auto config to allow it to pick up all of the different types of information that are used in this particular field or this particular unit. And I don't, there's some of these toward the bottom I don't care to see. I'm going to back up until we get to weight. And you'll notice that the type is read-write. If I change this to read-only and I click OK, what I've got when I go into run mode is a display-only field of the last 5 units. And you can see all the keyed items here are items that are locked. Those items can't be changed. So I've essentially created a view-only environment for some batch data for my ProcessBook display. Now if I want to go edit this and I want to change any of these parameters, I simply go into build mode, right-click, and select at the very bottom properties, and I can come in here and adjust the different aliases that I see. I can go to source and adjust if I want to see the last 4 unit batches or 3 or 10, however I want to display it. And then some of the other settings here allow us to, for visual, like a 3D appearance or flat or refresh interval, scroll bars, whatever, however you want to do it. And it's also got a section for custom names if you happen to be using custom names. Again, under some of the defaults are column widths, row heights, things like that. And you also have control over fonts and colors used. So that's a way to create a read-only datasheet control. What if we want to take our datasheet control and make it an interactive application? Well, to do that, we simply go to build mode, right-click on our datasheet control, and select properties. And I'm going to change the weight to read-write. And changing that to read-write will allow me not only to read data, but write data back to the Pi server. Now, there's a couple of settings here that are important to configure. First of all, if you don't want any controls over who writes data or what gets written, you just check automatically commit entered values, and then as long as someone was logged in with the correct credentials, they would be committed as soon as they were changed. But that's not really what we recommend. We recommend that you leave that unchecked and that you consider using some of the regulatory controls. Data quarantine will mean that someone will have to commit the data. And this could be anybody, or you could use someone from the PyAdmin group or whatever group you put together. And if it requires an e-signature, you can also force somebody to have to log in and sign in, and it'll display this message, sign in for electronic signature. And this gives someone both an approval and an audit trail for your data entry. So let's see how that might work. Let's say I want to change. Let's say this unit batch 1270 shouldn't have been 486825. It really should have been 4700. So I will change this to 4700.00. And you notice when I press enter, the field turns red. That means the data has been changed, but it hasn't been committed to Pi. If I right-click and select commit, that will, if I didn't have the e-signature, that would have just committed it. But since I have the e-signature in effect, that means someone actually has to type a password in who is known in this machine to be someone in the PyAdmin group, and then that will force that change to be verified. So it really puts a couple roadblocks up to making sort of random changes to your batch data.